impressive resume. 4.0 GPA in your business classes and 3.5 overall. 4 years on the debating team.
That's right.
Now, really, how was that experience?
Wonderful. I mean, exciting to say the least. We traveled all over the country, probably went against future politicians, governors, mayors. Bottom line, Mrs. Johnson, is I'm a go-getter, and I'm a hard worker. And I would be honored if you would give me an opportunity right out of grad school to start with your company.
Well, you applied for a data entry position. I mean, I have no doubt that you would do well given your skill set, but where do you see yourself within this company within 10 years?
Honestly?
Honestly.
See myself as the HR manager.
My job.
Yes, ma'am.
I like your ambition. Welcome, Johnson and Shaw.
Really? Look, Ms. Johnson, thank you for the opportunity. All right, I promise you won't regret this. All right, best decision you ever made. I'll see you on Monday.
Payton, he took it to the left side and wound up going into two defenders. That was just a great play to split those two defenders by Cole Anthony to get into the paint.
What's up, Rob?
My man, right on time. Hey, I ordered us some beer.
Thanks.
Tell me we're celebrating. Tell us we're celebrating.
Hide on the spot. Yeah. Hey, look. Paying all that good right now, but hey, it's a start, right?
Man, stop tripping. It's a J. Guess all them late night study sessions with Jasmine paid off, huh? Hey, you better call in and thank her.
Man, dude, don't even bring that girl up. You know it took my whole senior year just to get her ass out of my head.
A better number still saved in your phone. Hey, what you got it saved on?
As in don't answer? As in I'm done answering all these mood-killing ass questions? Man, come on, man.
I'm bad.
Good shot.
Hey, you see them chicks over there?
Where?
Let's go say her.
Yeah?
Let's go say her.
Oh, hell no, man. Hey, look at them. Look, all they gonna do is ask us to buy them a drink, and we ain't even gonna get no play. Between me and you, I'm down to my last $10. And I need that to get home on the train.
You can't let money interfere with fate. Walk! You're getting fat anyway. Besides, one of them could be Mrs. David Russell.
Maybe we gotta find you a job. You watching way too much rom-coms when you broke. Look at her though. Yeah, they are fine.
I want that.
You know what? Come on. Let's go. Good evening, ladies. How are you doing this evening?
Oh, we're good. We're just here to have drinks, so.
Sorry, I don't mean to interrupt, but my friend over here thinks that you are absolutely breathtaking. And he wanted to know if he can have the privilege and honor of just knowing your name.
Oh, can your friend talk?
Yes, I can, beautiful. My name is Rob.
My name is Michelle, and this is my friend, Stacy.
Hi.
How you doing, Stacy? My name is David.
Nice to meet you, David. And congratulations on your new job. Yeah, I did. You guys were pretty loud.
Look, I'm sorry about all that. but thank you anyway.
Look, no need to apologize. That is something most definitely worth celebrating. How about I buy you a drink?
Actually, I was going to see if I can buy you a real drink.
Oh. You were? How about you save your last $10 for something else?
You heard that too?
Uh-huh.
Oh, man, how embarrassing.
Look, things are about to change, right?
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
Just know that you are a loud drunk. So, what do you do?
I'm an entrepreneur.
Oh, how exciting. You know, I thought about doing that as well, but I'm just so scared to quit nursing. Anyway, so what field are you in? Real estate? You got your own coffee shop.
I drive Uber. You okay?
I'm good.
Yeah, girl, I'm a hustler. I just signed up on Lyft, too.
Oh, my God.
So I'm going to give you a call, right?
No, you're not. How you going to do that? I haven't even given you my number.
Well, you're going to give it to me, right?
I'm not looking for a relationship.
Well, neither am I. Look, I can cook you something. You like soul food?
I'm from Louisiana. What you got?
Oh, see, okay. I got some smothered chicken and rice, some mac and cheese, some candy yams, some cornbread that'll knock your socks off, girl. That's what you say. You know, I buy my groceries, I come to your house.
No, I'll come to your house. Give me your number. And no funny business either. I always carry my nine.
Oh, no guns. I carry my nine too.
Well, it was a pleasure to meet you, Stacy.
Likewise, Mr. David.
Look, I'm going to give you a call and we'll set that thing up.
You better. Don't make me regret giving you my number.
Oh, I promise. Have a good night.
You too.
Well, text me when you make it home, okay?
Will do.
Bye. Oh, man. Tonight was a good night.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If only you could see what I see when I look in your eyes, then baby, you know just what it feels like when you get butterflies. You turn my frown into a smile. You lift me up when I'm feeling down. And for that I say thank you. Baby, can I sing to you? Sit back, relax, get comfortable. Girl, I just wanna take my time and make you feel alright. Sing it with me like.
This fruit is so amazing. Mm-hmm. I had a great time with you today. Bike riding, feeding the fish. I mean, the seagulls were cool too. So they almost ripped my finger off.
That's because you're supposed to throw the food up in the air. Not supposed to hold out your palm and let me eat from your hand. Come on, you're not feeding no damn shih tzu. You know, I'm really glad that you came out here with me today.
Yeah.
I'm even more glad that you had a good time. You know, I come out here a lot. You know, kind of think and relax, you know?
Yeah. You know, this scenery will most definitely make you forget about the river.
Indeed.
So when was the last time you were here? You know, just to relax.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
Probably about a year or so. You know, I used to come out here early in the mornings and just swim as far as I could. From her.
Her? What do you mean?
Somebody I used to date. It was funny. We started off as good friends, you know. We had mutual friends, so we used to always hang out together, party together. Mm-hmm.
probably said bye and hugged 1,000 times. Just one day after a group study session, we hugged goodbye and I don't know, something was different. You know, something sparked. So we went out a couple times, you know, kissed, held hands, and expressed feelings for one another, you know, all that honeymoon crap. Did everything you do in a relationship, but we never had sex though.
Really? I mean, why not? What was holding you two back?
Well, she was kind of already involved with somebody else.
Oh.
And so she didn't want to cheat on her boyfriend. At least not sexually, anyway.
Sounds like she was leading you on. I'm sorry.
No, it's cool. You know, after a while, I just told her I couldn't do this anymore and stop answering her calls.
Hmm. You must really loved her, huh?
Yeah, I did. You know, the funniest thing is I didn't even realize how much until I ghosted her, you know?
So, do you still love her? I mean, have you truly moved on?
Oh, yeah. But trust me, that ship has sailed a long time ago. It's only one woman that has my interest now. One woman that has my full, undivided attention.
Oh, yeah? I wonder who she is.
When I look in your eyes, then baby, you know just what it feels like when you get butterflies. You turn my frown into a smile. You lift me up when I'm feeling down. And for that, I say thank you. Baby, can I sing to you? Sit back, relax, get comfortable. Girl, I just wanna take my time and make you feel alright. Sing it with me like. You make me feel like I'm all yours and you're all mine. As long as I got you and you got me, everything will be just fine. I'ma bring it home to you, hey, like your man's supposed to do. You ain't got to worry, no. I'm not out with the games no more.
So who knew the Uber Lyft entrepreneur was such a great cook and a wonderful dancer?
I did. I'm happy you found out, though. See? Can't go judging the car by the rim.
You fucking it up, but okay. So, I see you really love cooking. You take a lot of pride in it. You ever thought about, you know, doing it full time?
So put my Uber Lyft business on a back burner?
Yeah, I mean, you can always come back to that. You know what? I got a friend that got his own restaurant, and he's looking for a cook.
You're dry. Thank you. But I'm a chef, not a cook. I don't want to work for anyone.
Can do this. We all got to start somewhere. You have your own catering business in no time.
And one more thing.
What's that?
I'm never dry.
Ms. Johnson, I'm gone for the day.
Where are you going in such a hurry?
Oh, I got a hot date tonight.
Oh, go ahead with your bad self.
Look, I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
All right, okay.
All right.
Don't bring that. No.
Thank you for that wonderful meal, babe.
You're welcome, babe. Happy 1 year anniversary.
Same to you.
I got a little something for you.
You do? My favorite words. You have something for me?
Hey, baby, you got a little lipstick on your teeth.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, man, babe, you know I hate that. Baby, there's nothing on my...
Stacy. Maybe I love you so much. I mean, from the first day that I met you, I knew there was something special about you. Something special about us. You make me want to believe in myself again. You're perfect. Because of you, I believe in miracles. Because I know God made you just for me. I wake up every morning so happy and joy on my spirit and my heart, and I want to continue to have that type of happiness every day for the rest of my life. So I'm asking, Stacy, will you marry me?
Yes. Yes. Yeah? Yes.
David finally put a ring on it, huh?
Yes, he did.
Look at that rock, girl. It's gorgeous.
Thank you.
And what do you mean, finally? We've only been dating a year.
Oh, yeah, babe. You all can put the table there. Ooh. All right, that's it for now. You can go ahead and take a break.
Thank you.
Wait. You're thirsty, right? Mm-hmm. Can you all get us some water?
What? I thought we was on break. Go ahead, rest from barking orders. Y'all must be parched, huh?
Man, come on, man. You're
so good to me, babe.
He's so nice.
What's wrong with you, man? Come on, man, you know what they say, right? Happy wife, happy life.
Hey, why ain't they got no slogans for men? Like, most sucky, happy hubby. Something wrong with you, man.
Come on. True.
And I always knew you'd be the first one to get out the game. These streets ain't shit.
Hey, so how it feel to be making that plunge? Man, I'm not gonna lie. It feel good, man. I mean, she's perfect, dude. I mean, she's beautiful. She's smart. She got a good job. I mean, we don't argue. We don't fight. She don't complain. I mean, none of that silly shit. She laugh at all my corny-ass jokes. Oh, and getting it every night. I mean, every night, getting it in. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm going out on top like MJ, baby.
You must be forgetting them years at Washington.
Hey, so when the wedding anyway?
In 3 months, dude. I can't wait, bro. Hey, it's gonna be off the hook. I'm only doing this once.
But that's perfect. Now your best man can come up with your best little party.
Yeah. Hey, you better make it epic too.
Oh, it's gonna be dope.
Yeah, I'm serious.
And then we can see if you and her survive cohabitation. You know?
Cohabitation? What you mean by that? I mean, I know I'm moving into her apartment and all, but you know, ain't shit gonna change, man. You know that.
Nah. Nigga, do you hear yourself? You don't even believe that shit.
what I'm saying. I mean, yeah, it's her apartment, but she gonna know I'm the man of the house.
Yeah.
See, I'm the man.
You the man.
I'm gonna put my foot down.
Put the foot down.
Put the rules down. You know how it go.
This shit ain't gonna last.
Hey, what you mean by that, man?
So, he paying the bills, right? We haven't quite discussed that just yet. I mean, the rent is really high and he doesn't make a ton of money.
Girl, he broke?
No, he's not necessarily broke, but he's not on a nurse's salary.
I hear you, but I make Rob pay the rent and the cable bill.
You do?
Yeah, he want to go half on everything. I told that nigga, we ain't roommates. I don't fuck my roommates.
Michelle, Rob cannot afford your lifestyle.
I mean, I help out with the food and the lights and some other stuff.
Yeah.
But it's not all about the money.
Yeah, you're right.
I love his silly little ass. And girl, he loves me.
He is silly.
Every day after work, we take a shower and he rubs my feet.
What?
And he tells me about his day.
Sounds like he'll be popping a big question pretty soon.
Girl, I already told him my ring size.
You didn't.
7. And you know, I don't care how much the ring costs, but it gotta be at least 2 carats.
2 carats?
Yeah.
Wow.
David? Is that you?
Jasmine?
Oh my gosh! It's so good to see you. I love the suit.
Thank you. Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm looking at the newest team member of Exquisite Marketing.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm actually about to meet up with my girlfriends at the bar to celebrate. You should come and give us a time to catch up before I move to Austin.
Moving to Austin, huh?
Yeah.
Good. And see, you're putting that business degree to work, I see.
Indeed.
Look, I would love to come, but I can't. I gotta be somewhere.
I get it. You still have my number?
Yes, I do.
Well, then I look forward to hearing from you.
Okay.
It was good seeing you.
Likewise.
Hey, babe, that's you?
Oh, hey, babe. I didn't mean to wake you.
It's okay. How was your day?
Long.
Anything interesting happen?
No. Just same old, same old. Good night, babe.
Good night.
My dude, you showed so much restraint by not taking that drink with Jasmine. Apart from the obvious, though, being Stacy. Why didn't you?
Why didn't I? Are you serious? Let me ask you a question, man. Would you give an alcoholic a drink? Or a fat kid on a diet some cake? Or better yet, a junkie a hit? Yeah.
So Jasmine a bad drug?
The worst kind, my dude. The worst kind.
Crack.
Yeah. More like meth. You hear what I'm saying?
One hit, Stacy gonna be putting up posters, passing out flyers, asking strangers, have you seen this man?
Man, whatever, dude. Look, that's why I had to get up out of there. You see what I'm saying? Look, I got a good thing going with Stacy. I ain't trying to mess that up, you know? I mean, she's smart, she's beautiful. She take good care of me. Look, I don't need any distractions, and I damn sure don't need any worries, if you know what I'm talking about.
So how's she look?
Dude, finer than a motherfucker, man. I'm telling you, man, she has not changed since college. I mean, her smile, her hair, her lips, her feet, them legs, that body, that ass. Boy, still looking good. Rob, man, what the hell you doing?
Don't stop. How her ass tastes.
Man, shut the hell up, man. You stupid fool.
I forgot you ain't went that far.
Whatever. Oh, you know she moving to Austin, right?
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
So that's the universe doing you and Stacy a favor. Stacy love you. Stay away from Jasmine Farnaz.
You know you're not helping, right?
I'm not supposed to.
Yeah, you're right. She is finer than a motherfucker, though, boy. My mama got some good genes, you hear what I'm saying? She gonna mess around and get her bills paid. Not by me, though.
Oh, I'm home.
Hey, babe. Long day or what?
Yeah, no idea. But I'm home now. Getting some work done?
Yeah. My supervisor granted me with the pleasure of writing her oral presentation for tomorrow's meeting. Tony quit, so now I'm gifted with more responsibility. And the pressure if it all goes wrong.
Any raise in pay?
No. Well, not yet, at least. Hopefully, if this all goes well, I'll eventually be shift supervisor.
Well, I know everything's gonna work out in the end.
I hope so. You hungry?
Hell yes. I had to skip lunch today. I had so much work to catch up on. What you got?
Chicken salad.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Did you get my favorite dressing?
I did.
The balsamic?
Yes.
You know I like that. That's what I'm talking about.
I got you.
Oh, man. Let's see what's on this TV. News. Look at that, baby. More drama.
Yep, as usual.
Oh, thanks, Stace.
You're welcome, babe. Just make sure you don't waste any of that on my couch. You know I usually don't allow people to eat over there.
Excuse me?
What?
This is your couch? You usually don't let people eat over here? Look, babe, this is our house now, okay? Which means this is our couch. And I can eat anywhere I want to, all right?
Take it easy, babe, okay? I didn't mean anything by it. Look, I just like for things to stay nice and neat.
Yeah, okay.
Besides, I paid $3,000 for that couch, and I got it before we met, so...
So what? What you trying to say? What, I wasn't shooting with you in the gym? Is that what you trying to tell me? You know what? I'm gonna go buy my own couch. And that way I can sit there, eat there, sleep there, and do whatever I want to. How about that?
Why are you frontin'? Now you know you need to save up.
Oh, so you talking shit now?
Don't curse at me.
Man, I say whatever the fuck I want to. How about that?
You know what? Look, let's not do this, all right? I don't even know why we're arguing anyway.
Something about this being your house, your couch, your rules when I pay half the bills up in here. That's what this is about.
Really, David? Really?
I'm just gonna go take a shower. Thank you for dinner.
Unbelievable.
Put it down, down, down. We don't need no candlelight. We don't need, we don't need. can see the fire in your eyes. Intoxicated off your cherry wine. The sweet love between your thighs. Let's make love all night.
Hello?
Hey.
Look, I'm headed to work.
Okay.
Hey, look, I'm sorry about last night. I really didn't mean anything by it.
Look, I know. Okay, just... listen, all is forgiven. It's in the past.
Okay, so I'll see you later?
You bet. Have a good day at work.
You too.
My girl, she wants to walk away. I wanna talk. We can't find no result. Hello.
Ms. Johnson, you wanted to see me?
Yes, come, come. Have a seat, have a seat.
Is something wrong?
Oh, no, no, no. On the contrary. I just want to thank you for a great job that you are doing. Much appreciated.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson. I'll try.
Listen, we're having a supervisor training session next week. And I'd like to know whether you're interested in the junior coordinator position.
Are you serious? Absolutely. I mean, of course I would be. I mean, yes, I accept.
Well deserved. Get your affairs in order, because I need you in Austin all next week. And Rita will give you your transportation information and your meal vouchers.
Did you say Austin?
Yes. Is there a problem?
No. Of course not. It'll be great.
Then it's settled.
Just great.
And don't have too much fun on 6th Street, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Good job.
To my boy David's promotion.
That's me.
And to having more options in and outside of work. And enough to buy furniture, cash, money.
Okay, I see what you did.
We toast.
Hey, how much money are we talking anyway?
50% raise.
Oh. Mm. Ah, my. Ooh. Drinks should be on you.
Yeah, whatever. You taking me out. Oh, man. Oh, tell me, man. How's the cooking job coming? Oh,
man, I love it. I think I finally found my calling, you know? Sometimes I peek out the back to see the customers enjoying their food that I prepared, and it's the best feeling in the world.
Man, that's what's up, man. Hey, no bullshit, man. I'm proud of you, dog. Not gonna lie, I was kind of worried for a minute, man. I didn't know how long you could be a Uber, Lyft, Lyft, Uber driver, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I know you like your freedom and all, but
yeah, freedom's cool, but it's nothing like stability, you know?
Hey, spoken like a man.
Huh? Hey, give it a couple years and I think I'll be ready to own my own restaurant. Yeah, you know, Michelle's aunt got a diner that she used to have. And it's just sitting around collecting dust. I think I might ask her about it.
Man, you should, dude. Why sleep on it? And I see you and Michelle coming right along. Everything good, I see, huh? I mean, y'all shacking up and shit now, huh?
We make it work. You know, I cook, she cleans, and everything we disagree on in between, she's right.
Hey, man, that's how the life is. Like I always say, happy wife, happy...
You know it.
All right.
Hey, speaking of wife... What'd she say about the promotion?
I haven't told her yet. I'm gonna tell her tonight when I get home.
Remember, Austin is a business trip.
Oh, here you go.
Hey, keep the fun at home, sir. Peace is at home.
Hey, look, I'll drink today.
The next shot's on you.
Ooh, I got it, I got it. Hey, two more.
Mr. Promotion Man.
Hey. 50%.
50%?
From a Corolla to a Camry.
What?
You're
gonna be picking them up. You do.
Yeah, well, you know. Yeah. Pop a rubber band on her ass, make it count stack. Trying to hold me down, but I still bounce back. Yeah. Kelly style 6'4 when I bounce stack. Mix lemon with Henny and burn Supreme gas. I always think about winning, that's why I'm never last. Ooh, I got them hating and they reaching it. They reaching it. Go get your own and start reaching. I got old paper, new money, past bitches, new hoes. Same circle, new foes, no love, new goals. Drove clouds in the sky and I'm on the ninth one. You have a problem with your bitch cause you act like one. Yeah, add it up and improve like I'm supposed to. Clean house and make moves, I never plan to lose. Add it up and improve like I'm supposed to. Clean house and make moves, I never plan to lose. Closer I get to you. None of that hate shit. The better you make me feel, it's so real. Over and over again.
Ray Davis.
With that old big old banana peel head looking ass boy, Mark.
Man, why he gotta be all that? But no, it's over. But I do have a guy that I've been seeing every now and then for about a year.
Okay, okay. I think we call those booty calls.
I like to think of it as us just enjoying each other's company for the moment.
And I like to think of it as that slick way of trying to put it. But you know what? Look, I get it, all right? Mama got needs too, right?
Listen, my job is so demanding. I barely even have time for me. And I love it though. You know, I'm the only female in the department.
Oh, and I know you love the challenge of trying to show those men up at work.
And you know me so well.
Not as well as old dude.
David.
Sorry. I gotta take this.
Sure.
Hey, how you doing? Yeah. I miss you too. Hey, look, I'm about to eat some dinner right now, okay? So let me finish up here and I'll give you a call back and you can hear my voice for as long as you want. Yeah?
Okay. I love you too. Bye. Sorry about that. I had to take that call.
So, you married? I don't see a ring.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm engaged.
I see. Lucky woman.
Actually, I'm the lucky one. She's a good girl. I mean, she always there when I need her. She never keeps me at her arm's reach. She knows what she wants.
She let you fuck?
Well, yeah, that too. That's one of her better qualities.
Look, David, you know what we have had was special. I know you felt it.
Of course I did. I never felt that way about anyone before.
Now?
Let me ask you. Did you ever love me?
David, of course I did. I was with Mark and I was in the church and I didn't want a lot of God or Mark.
And what about yourself, huh? What about me?
It just wasn't our time, you know?
Well, I guess it still isn't.
Let's go grab some dinner, shall we?
Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. How are we doing today?
Good.
So we all know why we're here today, right? We're talking about upgrades to management positions, right?
Yeah.
Well, my name is Courtney Washington. Give you a little background on me. I graduated with my master's from Texas Southern University. I've been here with the company about 4 years now. I love what I do. We're going to go into an orientation today. We're going to talk about some things, housekeeping, what's expected of you from the company, what department you'll be heading up, and how many people you'll be managing. Housekeeping.
Beach looking at the hotel walls.
I see I'm your alternative again, huh?
Now you know what it feels like, huh?
Ouch. You really never gonna let me live this down, huh?
Well, never is such a long time. Well, how about we'll just see?
How about we start with these mochas?
You know, actually, I can't even believe you remembered.
Of course. How could I ever forget your favorite flavor coffee?
Man, it's beautiful out here. Hot. It's nice.
Better than that used to be.
So tell me, how are you adjusting to your new city?
Oh, you know what? Honestly, I love it here. The music, the art, the culture. I never have a hard time finding marketing inspiration.
Last time I was in Austin was, the Texas Relays. You remember that?
How could I forget? It was 8 of us in a 2-bedroom hotel.
Man, we slept head to foot.
Everybody except for Rob. He was poking my girl in the back with his junk all night. He pitched a tent for at least 2 hours.
Till it caught blue balls. Shit, man. My man was in hella pain. Rob ain't seen that much ass in one room in his life. You hear me? Boy lost his damn mind.
How is Rob anyway?
No, he's good. Oh, you know he's a cook now.
Wait. Are we talking about the same Rob?
Mm-hmm. Same old Rob. You know, he's actually dating my fiance's best friend.
That's cute. I bet y'all have cute little game nights on Thursdays, huh?
Uh-huh, real funny. Actually, Michelle, that's Rob's girlfriend's name, she kind of suggested that we start game nights. Who knows? Maybe we'll start.
Maybe you should. I know what we should start.
What?
We should start walking.
Come walking? We just sat down, Jasmine.
Come on, I got some stuff I want to show you.
Man, y'all walk too much in Austin for me, man. Where's the Uber, Lyft, something?
Let's go this way. It's right over here up the hill.
Lee.
Up the hill.
Up the hill?
I never thought that anyone would find a time to get in my mind.
But you the one to figure it out.
It's crazy how people come in around and claim they're holding you down.
But you the one to figure it out.
I don't understand what happened when you came from different angels. You became my angel.
You the one to figure it out.
I never thought that anyone would find a time to get in my mind.
But you the one to figure it out.
Crazy how people come in around and claim they're holding you down.
But you the one to figure it out.
I don't understand what happened when you came from different angels. You became my angel.
You the one to figure it out.
Hey baby, no, it's kinda crazy that you call me and you're holding me down. You see, you got me from the bottom to the top, and I'm feeling finally coming around, yeah. You pulled me out my shell when I was just single and selfish. And sometimes I even got a little bit hellish. Oh, we hit glory. I think I found my West Side story.
Had a good time, man.
You know, I called you for a year straight. No texts, no emails, no nothing. And it really hurt me. And for a while, I couldn't even understand why until I finally realized I was really being a bitch. I was selfish. I wanted you whenever, wherever, and I didn't promise you anything. Not even sex.
You know, it was never about the sex.
Sometimes it's about love and sex. You want to come up?
Yeah. So I should go.
Good night, baby.
Good night, Jasmine. Hey, babe. How you doing? How was your day? Mine? It was okay. Well, I miss you too. Did go by pretty fast, didn't it?
So you headed back to Houston tomorrow?
Yep. Right after the conference, back on home.
I would ask you to come up, but the last time I did that...
Yeah, Jasmine, look, I don't think it's a good time right now. Wait. Look, I can't do this. All right? I have a fiance. She's a good woman. She don't deserve this. I gotta go. Good night, Jasmine.
Still, I find myself asking,
do you still think of me?
you don't know what you got until it's gone. Till it's gone. It's the reason why I'm writing you this song. Girl, I'm slipping, and I don't know what to do. Girl, I admit it, I'm sick of you. Damn, I realize my mistake, my pride got in the way. I should have begged you.
I don't want this to end.
Me neither.
May, is that you?
It is I. The one she calls Bay. Ah, come here, girl.
I miss you so much.
I miss you. Oh, God.
Don't ever leave me for that long again.
Look, I won't, all right? At least not for a little while. Okay? Look, I'm just happy to be home. Conference went well and all, but.
Oh, it did?
Missed you. What is that? That smells wonderful.
Baked chicken.
Somebody love me.
I do. Mm-hmm.
You know, you're so good to me, right?
I know.
Okay. Right here, huh?
Oh, hey, baby,
what,
baby.
What?
Calm down, babe. Look. What? You'll get your dessert after dinner.
Okay. I like that. Well, let me go get washed up then.
Yeah, you do. Ah. Wait.
Oh, sorry. I'll be back. Mm-hmm.
Bert, this is good. You really put your foot in this one.
Thank you. So how was your trip? I mean, you called late a couple of nights while I was asleep, and most days I barely spoke to you at all.
It was cool. I mean, kind of boring, actually. You know, manager stuff and all. Is that?
Yeah. So anybody that you knew?
No. I mean, not really. Pretty much all strangers. Why do you ask?
Just asking. Look, there's an opera tomorrow. Would you like to go?
Come on, babe. You know I don't like coming to that kind of stuff.
All right.
What did I do for you to ask me to go?
Nothing. I mean, not that I know of. Look, I'm just asking because you've been gone an entire week and I figured we'll do something that I actually enjoy.
Okay. You know what? Okay. You know what? You're right. All right? Anything that you want to go. You want to go to the opera? We go to the opera.
Opera it is.
It's good though, babe. I mean, did you use some new seasoning or something like that? I mean, this is the bomb. Holding me tight.
to the day before we met. Skip my regret.
Why aren't you getting dressed?
Baby, you look stunning.
And you look like you're not going.
Look, it's not that. It's not that I don't want to go, babe. It's just, look, I had a long week and I'm tired. I just want to relax and watch some TV. I mean, maybe Michelle can go with you.
Michelle is out with her own man. And I thought that I can go out with mine. You know what? I'll just go by myself. Again.
Babe, it's not like that, all right? It's
exactly like that.
Look, you'll have a good time going alone. I mean, can I get a kiss?
Kiss my ass.
You know, no matter how many times I've seen this concert, it always reinforces the fact that in life we have choices, even if we feel that we don't.
Ebony had a choice, right? To be with her king or die.
Touche. Yeah, but what's the purpose of living if you can't feel for the person you're with?
You're right.
So I guess your husband didn't want to come with you tonight, huh?
My fiancé isn't interested in the opera. Oh.
Well, there is no way in the world I would allow a woman, as beautiful as you are, come to a concert as nice as this one, dressed as stunning as you are tonight.
So where's your wife?
Happily single.
Well, I guess this is me.
Oh, I didn't catch your name.
Happily engaged.
Okay. Well, listen, before you go, there's another show here next week, 7:30. Miss White. It'd be really nice to see you.
Good night, happily single.
Good night.
Hey. Why are you staring at me?
Just admiring my fiance.
Yeah. How was the opera?
It was great. Gave me some things to consider.
Like?
Choices.
Choices, huh? Look, babe. I'm sorry I didn't take you to the opera tonight, all right? But I promise to make it up to you. I mean, any other time you want to go, we can go. How about that?
Look at you. There's one next Saturday.
Ooh, is it next Saturday?
Next Saturday.
Upcoming Saturday. Ooh, baby, that's rival week. You know, rival week. I mean, any other weekend besides that, I promise you.
Okay.
All right. Oh. Look, I'll be in the bed in a minute, all right?
No, you won't. You made your bed on that couch. I'm not lying.
Stace, you're joking, right? I see what you did there. That was cute. Stace, you're not serious. Stace? Can I get a blanket?
So you mean to tell me that nigga chose a football game over taking you to the opera?
Yes.
Can you blame him?
Michelle.
I'ma just keep it real. Niggas ain't trying to go see no opera.
He could have recorded the game. Like, what about me?
Opera is some white people shit anyway. I don't know what they be saying.
But I even gave him a chance to make it up to me. I was like, okay, well, we can go next Saturday.
You tripping. That's rivalry week. You know, like Michigan versus Notre Dame. Prairie View versus Texas Southern.
And?
Ain't nobody missing that.
I know somebody who might.
Girl, what you talking about?
Nothing. Pretend like you didn't hear that.
Bitch, I don't live in pretend land. Spill the tea.
Fine. Okay, so after the concert, while I was waiting on my ride, this handsome, mature guy was hitting on me. I mean, he's a little older and a little bald, but he's nice and he has a great smile.
Oh, sound like Obama trying to hit. Excuse me, young lady, can I tap that ass?
It wasn't like that at all. He was intriguing. I don't know. But he did ask me to sit with him next Saturday, so.
Oh, so he ain't tripping on Labor Day Classic?
No.
Listen, I know at first I went on Davis bandwagon, but he's a nice guy. And you're engaged?
Yeah.
Don't let Mr. Clean ruin that.
Okay. I got it.
Carry inside, and you got to imagine Duke's going to try to exploit that and get the ball into the wood-to-work candidate as often as they can. Well, it was a great pass by Joey Baker because it was quick.
Come on. Defense. That's what I'm talking about. That's how you play D, baby. That's how you play D. Let's go.
How's the game going?
It's good, baby. They just tied it up. Hey, whoa. Is that a new dress?
We showed this on game day this morning against Florida State. That instead of taking on the big guy and splitting.
Never seen that one before.
He took it to the left side.
Oh, yeah. Let's go. Shoot. That's what I'm talking about, baby. That's how you play ball. Let's go.
Enjoy yourself tonight?
I did. Mrs. White was just as good as advertised. Thanks for inviting me.
Oh, no. The pleasure was mine. Mm. I mean, I had the privilege of having the most extravagant woman in the building on my side tonight.
Oh, yeah?
It's not too late. Mrs. Engaged.
Stacy. Call me Stacy.
Carl.
Excuse me?
My name is Carl. Your future man.
So, Mr. Carl, I mean, you're a nice, handsome bachelor. Why are you single?
Because I want to be happy.
Oh. Is that right?
Look, I'm not going to ruin this night talking to you about my ex. Mm-hmm. But what I will say is, I want a woman. A real woman. A woman who knows her value. A woman who can appreciate a ballet and an opera. And have the sexiest eyes in Texas.
So the eyes are a staple, huh?
They are definitely a contributing factor.
I really enjoyed tonight, Mr. Carl.
So did I. Sorry, but when can I see you again?
I don't know. I mean, I don't want to move too fast.
Okay, me either. So next Wednesday. Town and Country Movie Theater. 7:30. I'll pick you up on the north side.
I'll be there.
Come on. It's our turn.
Oh, hey, babe. How was the play?
The opera? It was fantastic.
Look, I'm sorry I couldn't go with you.
It's okay. The game has you entertained. Mm-hmm. And whoever that is blowing your phone up.
It's nobody.
I'll just get
it. You know what? I'll get it. I'll just... Hello?
Oh, you got me so wet. I cannot wait to have you between my legs.
Hey, Jeff. Look, man, I'm hanging with my fiance, all right? Look, I'll call you back tomorrow.
Okay.
All right, man. Bye. Crazy.
That Jeff guy must be really funny, huh?
Yeah, it's Jeff, the new guy at work. I mean, dude is silly, babe.
Got you laughing like that?
Yeah, he's pretty crazy.
I'm going to bed.
All right, babe. Well, I'll be there soon, all right? I'll come over there and hold you and we can... Okay. Guess I'm sleeping on the couch again tonight. Oh, God, it was close.
Hey. Look, I'll be hanging with some coworkers tonight after work. One of them is having a birthday party and I'm being dragged there.
Okay. Where are you guys going?
I don't know as of yet, but I do know I won't be home until around 9:30 or so. All right.
Hey, wait. I don't get a kiss goodbye?
Oh.
Guess you can call that a kiss. You look beautiful. Oh, you know you almost got me in trouble the other night, right?
I'm sorry. You just be having me all emotional and stuff.
Yeah, but you gotta watch what you're saying. I mean, she was like right there in front of me. Talking about you all wet.
You think she heard me?
I don't know. If she did, she didn't allude to that fact.
Well, look, whenever you're ready to make this a permanent thing, us, I'm with it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Really?
Okay, that was a good movie.
I told you that dude was the murderer.
All right, you were right, you were right.
You know I wanted to be there though, right?
I bet you did.
Shh.
Cute couple, right?
He was kind of old, but she was cute.
Yeah, but she wasn't you.
True.
You okay? You look like you just saw a ghost.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Are you hungry?
Not at the moment. So what movie did you see?
Friend Zone.
Good movie. Crazy ending, right?
Yep. Pretty insane.
Guy ended up with his true love. So, is that how this is gonna play out? You end up with your true love?
Man, fuck all that. Who was that nigga you was with?
You don't get to ask me no questions. Who was that bitch you was with?
You know, I never thought my fiance was such an accomplished liar. Oh, I'm going out with some friends after work. They're dragging me to a birthday party. Well, I didn't see that nigga dragging you anywhere, and I damn sure didn't see no birthday cake.
So, was that the bitch who texted you from Austin? Oh, I hope you made it home safe.
Wait. You went through my phone?
Yeah, I went through your phone, but I only went that one time. You said it only took one time. You can't take me to the opera, but you can text and call other women. Who is that, Jeff? I'm so wet. I can't wait to have you between my legs. You think I heard that either, huh? So who is she? How long you been seeing her? I mean, let's be real.
Since Austin.
What's her name?
Jasmine.
Jasmine. Jasmine from college, Jasmine? Jasmine that had you running behind her for years, Jasmine? Not even letting you sniff the chocha? She still got you wishing?
No.
Oh, so she paid her booty that time. But I hope it was worth
it. Are you fucking him or what?
No, but that's gonna change.
Really? So you like older dudes now?
I like grown, mature men who's not afraid to take that woman to the ballet or
out. So old dude is mature because he like to see motherfuckers in tights?
You couldn't even DVR a game for your woman. But I guess you thought you can DVR this relationship. Work like
it wasn't even like that. Stace, it wasn't even. Stace!
So is it really over?
Yep. You know he moved his things out a couple of weeks ago.
I can't believe it.
Me either.
I can't believe that girl finally gave him some. After all of these years. But you know, niggas will wait an eternity for that nookie.
That is not funny.
I know. I'm sorry. So, what's up with Mr. Clean?
Girl, he treats me like a queen. You know I've been over there these last couple of days, right? And when I tell you I don't have to lift a finger, I mean just that. He takes really good care of me.
Hmm. Look, when was the last time you worked?
Oh, I'm taking a week off.
Oh, so you switching dick like that, huh?
Look,
and now you don't want to work.
I am entitled to a break every now and then. I mean, I have vacation time. And what's wrong with letting your man spoil you? That is something these young guys know nothing about.
old school, spoiling you, huh?
Spoiling me.
Watch out. You don't get something for nothing.
Look, I know you mean well, but I'm good. I got it. I got it.
Okay.
Let's go. Let's get in together. Huh? What you want? What you want? Huh? Oh, whatever. You ain't got nothing. Huh?
Finally scored. Seems like you've been doing that a lot lately.
Ha ha ha. Not funny.
Stacy's a great girl. You traded her in for somebody who gave you a major heartbreak. I'm just trying to make sure she don't do that to you again.
Look, it ain't even like that anymore, bro. All right? And besides, we grown now. And she apologized for all that college BS.
So you all packed up, ready to move to another woman's house?
Oh, so you brought the jokes, huh? Yeah, I'm ready to go, man. And look, Miss Johnson thinks I'm ready to be an HR manager anyway. So that means I ain't gonna be at Jasmine's house for too long. Make my own money, get my own spot, make it look good.
I just hope it's worth ending a perfectly good relationship.
Dude, you act like she wasn't stepping out on me, man.
You was fucking Jasmine, bro.
Yeah, but she ain't know.
She knew. They always know. They smarter than us.
Yeah, I know, man. Look, whatever, all right? On to a brighter note. I'm gonna start working a new position, which means I make more money, and I get to wake up every day to the woman that I always wanted to wake up to. It's a perfect life, dude. What can go wrong? Man, that was the wind, man. In velocity, man. You know how the air, it's physics, man. The weather, pick up a book. I ain't got time to teach.
Your woman skills, just like your basketball skills.
Both trash. All right. Well, Miss Rose, your resume looks impressive. Let me ask you, what skills do you possess to contribute to this company?
Well, I'm detail-oriented, and I'm punctual, and I work well with others.
Well, that's an excellent answer. Well, Miss Rose, I feel comfortable moving forward with you. Your resume and your references back up your claim, and if you're interested, I would like to offer you the data entry position.
Yes, I would love that.
Fantastic. If you would, please see the reception on your way out to finish all the paperwork, and we look forward to working with you.
All right.
All right, congratulations.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
You too.
Hey, bae. How you doing? No, I'm fine. Good. Everything's good. Yes. I'll be home soon. Just wrapping up things now. Okay, see you soon.
I made you some coffee.
Hey, thanks, babe. I need it. Damn! You come home from working. Hope you're getting paid double for that.
I wish. Now I know what teachers feel like. We have this new client that wants us to promote his brand of socks, but he hasn't given us enough money for commercials or billboards.
Well, you're just gonna have to hit social media real hard. You know what? Find one of those YouTubers, right? And bloggers or whatever the case may be. They got over 1 million views and have them promote for you. Chuck them a couple dollars. They'll be more than happy to do it. Plus, that'll be good publicity for you. Now, if you're looking for older folks, then Facebook's the way to go. They're always on Facebook.
Babe, those are some really good ideas. Thank you.
No problem. Anything for my baby. Hey, babe. What's for dinner?
Oh, I had the munchies and I had takeout, so you gotta fend for yourself tonight.
Well, dang. So your man come home from a long day of work and you ain't got no dinner ready? Sandwich made? Nothing like that? I mean, what's up with that?
I wasn't tripping when I came in here and you wasn't in the kitchen slaving over my supper.
Supper?
David, listen. I probably should have told you before you moved over 200 miles that I don't cook.
Wait. You don't cook or you don't know how to cook? There's a difference.
Listen, I'm a feminist and I believe in equality. Non-gender roles in the workplace and at home. We're equal.
So you trying to tell me a brother can't get rice and steak because I have a penis?
You're not listening.
Okay, let me ask you a question, right? Let me get this straight. Let me ask you a question. If I was to make your favorite dish right now, would that make you less of a feminist?
Of course not.
Then you shouldn't feel like a feminist having to cook for your man. In fact, some of your single, manless, no sex having friends will probably be proud of you.
So what makes you think that I have feminist friends out here that's not having sex?
Because niggas ain't putting up with that shit. Straight up, we do not deal with that. Now, unless you got a white man or Asian, and you know and I know, they coming up short.
Babe, listen. Let's not fight. Let's make love instead.
Can't get hard on an empty stomach. Excuse me. I want to make love, but ain't got no damn Subway sandwich. Ramen noodles, serious, nothing. I want to make love.
Hey, babe.
Hey. Hey, babe, how was your day?
I swear, the people that I got working for me right now, but it need to be micromanaged.
That bad, huh?
Here.
All right. Are you okay?
I'm just glad this day is over with. I'll deal with all that madness tomorrow when I get back. Bae, rub my feet.
I got you.
What else? You cooking something?
Oh yeah, I have baked chicken in the oven.
Bae, you did not have to do that. I could have took care of that for you.
No, baby, it's okay. Look, I love cooking. Besides, I've been cooped up in this house for a while now. Shoot, I had to do something. I cooked. I cleaned. And I did the laundry.
Ooh, right there. Hey, what's that?
What?
Right there.
Oh, I stopped by the cleaners too. Those are my clothes for tomorrow.
Where you going tomorrow?
To work. You know, I've been gone for a week and a half now. Shoes, I better get back before they give my job away.
Hey. No, babe. I told you. You don't have to go back to work. I'm gonna take care of you.
Babe, look, I have my own house and my own bills.
Okay, well then sell your own house and put your money in your pocket.
Okay, Carl, that sounds great and all, but we're moving way too fast. Look, I enjoy my own spot and my independence.
Independence.
You know, Stacy, independent is for single people. So you need to decide what you want to do. Do you want to be single and independent? Or do you want to be happy with a man who loves you and want to take care of you for the rest of your life?
I can take care of myself. Look, I don't need you for that.
Oh, really?
Baby, all I'm saying is that I just need you to love me. That's it. Mm-hmm. Nothing more, nothing less. Look, I like working. I really love nursing. Please don't be threatened by that.
Threatened? Independent. I hope you know what that means.
Filling out my cup, coffee talk on the screen porch. So in love, now you're the one I'm losing sleep for. And I hope the wrong ones slip right through your magic fingers. And I hope we find some way to fall in love like we were. Yeah, you're the only reason I was California dreaming in the first place. Seeing you in sundress seasons got me all up in my feelings for the old days, old days. I've got the summertime blues, thinking about you and me in the way that it used to be. I still do think about you in the morning when I'm waking up. Laying in this bed without you, it's got me lonely and missing your touch. Yeah, you're the only reason I was California dreaming in the first place. Seeing you in sundress.
Grass ain't always green on the other side, is it?
Man. Come here to say I told you so, or come drink with your boy?
Both. Damn. You know, this tap beer sure do taste sweeter than a nigga, right? Where you staying at now?
North side of Austin. All I do is eat, sleep, and work. Man, I am done with women. And I am done with relationships. From now on, my work is my new woman, and I'm gonna give her my undivided attention.
And just like a woman, work is gonna tell you that you're not doing enough. Who are you talking to on the phone? Why you gotta be up so late? Do you love me? Oh, and the most nauseating words you can say to a man.
We need to talk.
Face it, man. We can't win with women or with work. Just gotta do our best and put up with they shit. What was the last straw with Jasmine anyway?
Besides the fact that she can't cook, she don't clean, she don't do nothing. Her process is what she calls it.
What's that?
Weed. The girl smoked like a chimney. I mean, every day, all day. In the house, out the house, in the car, out the car, in the bathroom. Hell, why she taking a shower? Can't get away from the stench.
I guess you couldn't smell the kush through all the badoosie in the air, clouded your judgment.
Man, at least we split on good terms, though, you know? I guess it just wasn't meant to be.
That's cool. You know, it's a good thing that work is your new woman, because you would not like to know how foreign Stacy looking these days.
Hey, say, man, don't be looking at my girl, man.
She not nobody's girl. At least for the last few months I done heard.
Dude, why didn't you tell me, man? You know she blocked my phone number, right? Blocked me from Facebook, blocked me from the gram.
Both of y'all needed space to heal. And find out what's truly important.
especially you. What's going on with that bullshit, man? Look, I need to see her, all right? I know. I'll drop by her place.
She moved.
I'll call her on the phone.
Her number changed.
Well, damn, Rob, help me out, man. How am I supposed to see her?
Girl, let's take a moment to just breathe.
Oh. I'm glad you chose Galveston to go running. I'm enjoying the breeze, but anything after 100 yards is my cool down. So you got all this energy since Mr. Clean has slowed down.
Slowed down? Shoot, it's more like a screeching halt. Girl, he wanted a different type of housewife. One that doesn't cook, doesn't clean, and have sex all the time. I couldn't do that.
Oh, the torture. What's his number again?
Don't do that. Now you know you have Roger. Besides, I just want it better for myself. You know how I feel about my independence.
Girl, any woman will let a man like that lock them up and throw away the key, girl. Shit, you can come visit me on the weekend like one of them felons.
Let me tell you what put a nail in our relationship. It's when he said he didn't want any children. You know how long I've been wanting to have kids? Shoes, I can see him now. Running around the house with me and my husband. Yeah, that was just something I just couldn't give up. I don't know. Anyways, one more lap.
Oh no, you go ahead without me. I'ma meet you back here.
You know, I appreciate you doing this for me, huh, Michelle?
I'm doing this for Stacy. And I can't promise you anything. And she may not even talk to you. Rob thinks you're truly sorry for what you did.
I am.
Destroying a perfectly good relationship? I hope you know what you want this time. Because if you hurt her again, she won't be the only one in this relationship with a hole in her heart. You feel me?
Yeah, I feel you.
What are you doing here?
I made it to see you.
That won't be necessary. I can walk.
No. Stace. Please, just give me a moment, okay?
What do you possibly have to say to me? Huh? Oh, that you and what's your name broke up? I mean, that is why you're here, right?
No. Look, Stacey, me and her broke up a while ago, okay? Look, I'm sorry. Can't get you off my mind. I've been thinking about you for months now. Look, Stace, I was wrong, okay? I thought I knew what I wanted, but I didn't. Being dishonest and unfaithful was the biggest regret, the hugest mistake of my life.
So it took you a few years to figure that out, huh? A few years of wasting my time to figure that out? Look, I forgive you, all right? You're off the hook.
What?
We just wasn't meant to be.
Wait, yes, we are. Listen, what if I don't want to be off the hook, huh? What if I want to be on the hook with you for the rest of my life?
I don't want to hear this. You know how many times I heard this? How do I know you don't have 1,000 other women stashed away waiting to fuck?
I promise, baby, please believe me. It's no one else, just you. Look, I only want two things in this world. One, to have us back together, for us to work.
And?
Stace, will you go to the ballet with me?
Of
I'm so sorry. I love you.
If only you could see what I see when I look in your eyes, then baby, you know just what it feels like when you get butterflies. You turn my frown into a smile. You lift me up when I'm feeling down. And for that I say thank you. Baby, can I sing to you? Sit back, relax, get comfortable. Girl, I just wanna take my time and make you feel alright. Sing it with me like. You make me feel like I'm all yours and you're all mine. As long as I got you and you got me, everything will be just fine. I'ma bring it home to you, hey, like your man supposed to do. You ain't got to worry, no. I'm not with the games no more. Baby, can I sing to you? Baby, on you. Sit back, relax, get comfortable. Girl, I just wanna take my time.
Won't you let me take my time?
Make you feel alright.
Make you feel right.